Welcome, armchair generals, weekend warriors, and Saturday soldiers alike. This is ostentatiousness, and holy shit, I'm loud. Internet, why didn't you tell me I'm loud? So when last we left off, still just fiddling around with my microphone again and looking where it pops up on my audio mixer, we had successfully defended Coruscant fairly well. I mean, compared to that Bestine space battle. The something I was actually going to explain before the Battle of Coruscant, though, was the Emperor's actually a terrible Sith. He gives into his passions, he gives into his... I just realized I left my fan on. He gives into his passions and all that. You know, lives pretty free for a Sith. However, the Baneite Sith believe there should always be two, the rule of two, the Master and the Apprentice. The Master to hold the power and the Apprentice to crave it. They also believe that the Apprentice should grow strong enough to kill the Master, and only the stronger Sith survives. If not, the Master trains a newer apprentice stronger because of the failed attack. I mean, there are many holes in that philosophy, but that's just the point of it. Darth Sidious, along with his master Darth Plagueis, attempted to obtain immortality, which completely defeats the rule of two. Neither Sith Lord would be able to die. Now, interestingly enough, they manipulated the midichlorians of the Force and tried to create immortality, or at the very least, life, and the Force railed against this and created Anakin Skywalker. Literally a virgin birth. He is the Jesus of his world. None of that is important. What is important is how I'm beginning my slow, inexorable march towards grinding the rebels into a fine paste.
Vehicle in production.
So, yes. We lost... lost. It's a relative term. I view that battle at Coruscant as effectively a loss. We held on, but barely. Just by the skin of our teeth. So, in this one, definitely Eriadu, Dagobah, and hell if I can squeeze the time out for it, I might also strike. Oh, sorry about that. I might also strike Vergesso. One thing I'm actually also looking into is getting a capture card, because I want to be able to record from my Xbox, and particularly I want to record Halo Wars 2. I mean, to a lesser degree, Halo Wars 1, but I played through Halo Wars 2 recently, and I really loved it. You know, always been a big fan of Halo. Always. I'll fight anyone who says otherwise.
Ready to go.
Recruiting troops.
So... yep. So, just kinda... chilling, waiting for my ground forces, if anything, to be complete.
Reporting.
It's actually funny because in all the movies and stuff, the Imperial Walkers, the AT-STs and the AT-ATs, are fucking beasts. You know, they easily tear through rebel formations. Yet in the game, the AT-ATs are joke. Anyway, we are now going to Eriadu. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. God, it must be a terrifying sight. Huh. Okay, first off, must be a terrifying sight. Just, you know, you're planning your rebellion and suddenly a fleet of Star Destroyers just jumps out of hyperspace. What just occurred to me is the reason why Imperial craft, TIE fighters and TIE bombers, you can't build them on their own is because they don't have a hyperdrive. So, a fairly important question is, what the fuck just happened? How does Vader keep magically teleporting TIE fighters? And yeah, I know the argument, oh, it's just fiction, you're reading too much into it. Fuck you, I'll read as much into it as I want to. I'm a grown man, and if I want to waste my time, I'll waste my time.
Remove their influence from the system by destroying all their defenses.
Right away.
Now, normally I would just go the straight route, which would mean that my forces would hook him. And again, random transports. You may dispense with the pleasure. I'm not going to say no to low-hanging fruit. I do enjoy low-hanging fruit.
What now?
Nowhere to run.
Now you will know true suffering.
Ready, sir. Roger.
I am ready now.
Well, this is about to get substantially more interesting.
Attacking target.
Do not fail.
I think that if the shields don't work in clouds of gas, I don't think that their lasers should work either. I mean, it's just me finding something to bitch about, but still. Well, it was going about as well as that that first Solus space battle went. Except with no Vader to swoop in and save the day. God, that's a sentence I never thought I'd say. Why do these things have guns? That's it. That's it. You're no longer defenseless bystanders. You're gonna die. If nothing else, I want to prove to the galaxy that I am a cruel god.
You will not escape this time.
Oh yeah, there's a space battle going on, isn't there? Yeah, kind of forgot. I used to drink a lot. I don't remember. I don't actually drink a lot, sadly enough. I work in a liquor store and I don't drink a lot.
Destroy the shield generator.
The rope finder has broken off from the main
room. Destroy the shield generator.
Every time he says come with me, I hear the chorus of the song, Whoa, come with me now.
They've destroyed our torpedo launcher. Ready, sir. Roger that.
God damn it, they are fucking us up. You sound so offended. And you presume too little, Vader. Well, this actually could have gone substantially worse. I would actually really love a Star Wars movie or game. Maybe not so much a game, but definitely a movie set during the Old Republic era.
Move to attack.
Once again, the rebels demonstrate that they're a bunch of fucking cowards, running and hiding from their inevitable death. I think these acclimators are actually fairly good point defense craft. Because they seem to be doing some pretty decent work, right? right now. Joke's on you, I'm already prepared. I've got a suitcase packed and everything. I love how I have to hunt down the last of the rebels, but no, they can just destroy my space station. No, they can just destroy the last of my assault ships. I am satisfied with what we took from them. I am not happy with what we lost. So.
Constructing unit.
Jeez. And now the land war in Asia. I mean, the land battle on Eridu. Ah, fuck, only two... Fuck. Only two platoons of, of walkers.
Choose your reinforcements.
That is the system.
Inputting coordinates.
No, that is the landing zone.
Moving out.
I know these things confuse you, Vader, but they shouldn't.
Moving out.
So one of the benefits that the rebels actually do have over the Empire is what basically amounts to the ability there, because the rebels rely on because the rebels rely on a lot of hovercraft, they can actually shoot straight to the landing zone, which means while I'm marshalling my troops, I love how also, once again, the rebels have basically just committed mass murder. You know, destroying these buildings. Now I understand, the Imperial citizens are drawing their weapons and fighting them. However, the rebels have occupied a city and just slaughtered the inhabitants. My empire now feels pretty justified in all of its horrific actions. Done. Dun, dun, dun. Also, I love how that's a Lambda-class shuttle. The, small detail most people would never notice, but...
Leave nothing alive.
We'll assist you.
It's just a really nice touch. That Vader gets his own personal shuttle. It's like when Han and Chewie are brought in. And... They get, they come in by the Millennium Falcon.
Support order acknowledged.
Don't know what the purpose of this is. Vader outrunning the entire Imperial army with his robot legs. Now, one of the I guess fan questions that I always think up is who would win between, or at least what kind of battle would we expect between, say, the UNSC from Halo and the Empire in Star Wars? Now this game, with how missiles and solid projectiles actually go through shields, pretty well highlights to me that, at the very least, the UNSC would have a significant advantage in that all of their weapons are solid, so they can go through deflector shields, which are keyed for energy. And people decide they want to fuck off, want to have a conversation right outside my door. Because, you know, reasons.
Alert all command.
Let's go.
Now remember, this fight's actually kind of a bitch. At least it was for my Rebellion playthrough. I don't know, you guys, oddly enough, would remember that better than I do.
Choose your reinforcements.
Right away.
Oop, just bump my microphone.
Two men follow me.
Ah, you're what I was looking for. Vader, do your biz.
Now you will meet your...
So this is a sensor array.
Copy.
Which, if I can capture it, means that I'll have pretty good omniscience over the battlescape. Which also means I actually wouldn't need to apply my forces to the fight itself. I could simply just call in bombing runs. They might be washing the dogs. Yeah, see, if I was the rebels and I'd sent troops across here, look at the hell I'd have to fight.
Make ready.
Of course, the rebels are streaming towards the landing zone as opposed to, oh, I don't know, the last fucking place they saw me. I do love when they realized that the bombing run was coming, how they all just kind of got the fuck out of Dodge.
Reinforcement point contested.
Follow me. Concentrating firepower. It will be done.
Attacking target!
Now we will know true suffering. It is useless to resist.
And then once they realize that I'm not actually in the place that they were contesting, they all come rushing back to die pointless deaths. For they are rebel scum. Oh, cool, they have a sensor. Ah, interesting. It seems like an entirely useless building, but interesting. I love the statue of some random Eldar warlock.
Prepare your men.
Really, really brings the place together.
They will be permanently damaged.
I would once again really love an Old Republic style, an Old Republic style.
There is no escape.
Star Wars movie where you get to watch thousands of Sith and thousands of Jedi just fight. That would be sweet. Love how I've lost a third of my walkers. God knows how many of my infantry invaders half dead.
Base is under attack.
Pause.
Prepare your men.
Interesting. That's very interesting. Cover should be useless against AT-STs, simply by virtue of the fact of how fucking tall they are. I don't know, it's just one of those things.
Now you will know true suffering.
Rebellion soldiers, lightly armed, but highly motivated. Yeah, motivated.
We are victorious.
Oh my god, that took way longer than it should have. I know I could pad things by just like having, oh, you know. Huh. Appear to have left the majority of my forces somewhere.
Crews are online.
Not to matter.
All too easy.
Constructing unit.
Inputting coordinates.
Training troops.
Don't know why I assigned a random
Crews are online.
Oh, that might be why. They might have actually been intended to reinforce this fleet. Holy shit. Everything makes sense now. I'm an idiot.
Constructing.
Although not that shouldn't really come as a surprise to anyone.
Reporting.
So, yeah.
Ready to go.
It's now mostly just Vader rebuilding his shattered army. However, by securing area do I have, for the moment, locked down Coruscant. And besides, look at all my money!
Constructing unit. Unit cancelled. Constructing unit.
Ready to go. Ready to go.
So, during this lull in the battle, you guys are going to need to tell me if, what my volume levels are like, if I need to crank things up, turn things down, move it all around.
Unit in production.
And, yeah, just let me... of pirates. Just let me know what kind of volume levels, like, if I need to fiddle with anything.
Ready to go.
Because I don't appreciate, I don't want to blow out your eardrums. It just naturally happens. So, last 8 minutes.
Crews are online.
Dagobah it is. It's the only planet that's a direct threat to Bespin. And it also means that I can shift this fleet here. However, I don't want to move my fleet.
Tartan crews are reporting.
Let's go.
Crews
are
online.
Wills.
Ready to go.
Tactical battle imminent.
Okay. Now then, those of you who aren't familiar with it, those of you who don't know what Dagobah is, it's the planet where Yoda showed up. So, also, doesn't mention here, swimming in the dark side. Thank you, Rebellion, for putting on such a nice astrobatic display for me.
Sensors are reporting that there is a hostile presence surrounding the planet. Lay waste to any forces that oppose the Empire.
Look, sir, it's them. Standing by.
Okay, this is going to be particularly interesting. Once again, not entirely certain why the Rebellion isn't using bombers. I mean, the Empire clearly has a capital ship heavy force. Ah, they have transports. It'll make my eviling much more eviled. So I have no idea what the fuck is going on right now. I think I can speak for everyone when I can say no one does.
Firing.
My dog says hi, by the way. Yeah, definitely getting barfed. She wouldn't be barking like this if she wasn't. This is another one of those fights where Vader would have come extremely handy. Oh well, we're officially fucked.
Standing by, enemy sighted. Targeting. Firing. Attacking. Locking. Enemies. Move to attack. Target confirmed. Destroy the torpedo launchers. Our lasers have been destroyed.
Well, oh, there goes one of my acclimators. Is that actually what they're called? Yeah, acclimator. Oh, actually, let's play how many aggressors do I have right now? Oh, only two. Weak. God, that was fucking funny. I do like the fact that I can just tell them to go and find shit and kill it. It's quite nice. God, I really wish they'd just run away at this point. It would literally make my day so much easier.
Roger that. We're in position. I got
one. Ready.
Form up. Target sighted. Attack. Our launch bay has been disabled.
Jesus.
Confirmed.
I think we can safely say that my fleet's seen substantially better days.
Open fire. Where'd he go?
Two of my ships hanging on for dear life, one of them almost there. I may have to retreat. Give the rebel scum time to pull out their forces.
Prepare for jump to hyperspace.
I might just actually do that. First major defeat of the game. Oh shit, no. Okay, so you're probably wondering why I did that. I had the realization that if I retreated, Vader and all of my infantry would jump straight into that. Oh dear. Well, got no more time for today. However, next time, which Saturday or Sunday, depending on how I'm feeling. Next time, we will conquer Dagobah, and then Naboo, then Vergesso. Again, I'm being a bit pedantic with how thorough I am in my conquest of the galaxy, but it's just kind of how I play. Anyway, I am ostentatiousness. You have also been you. If not, you should probably get that checked by a medical professional. And once again, guys, just tell me how the volume levels have been, what I need, you know, if I need to drop them or make them better, or make them better, raise them. You know, how am I too loud? Is the game too loud? I know I'm too loud, so how loud am I? Yeah. And remember, everyone, stay crunchy in milk. Bye.